Hi everybody, welcome to my video. I begin in the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, Amen. Dear loving Lord Jesus, I ask you again to help me as I record your words. Please dip every word I speak in your precious blood so that they reach all those you wish to communicate with. I ask this of the Father in your sweet and precious name, my Jesus. Amen. Now, this is a heavy-duty message from Jesus. It's merely entitled, Jesus Speaks, and I begin. Right, friend, right. And Jesus says, the pillars of the earth are crumbling, the foundation because of the lack of love. The foundation of the world was set on love. God formed the earth and the planets and the whole universe out of love. If love formed the earth and all that is therein, therefore it is reasonable to conclude that the crumbling of the foundation would come about because of the lack of love. The foundation was always tampered with. The crumbling always took place in some measure, but now it is obvious that it is crumbling faster and more viciously in many ways. The physical way, which is the outcome, the physical manifestation of the spiritual way. Because the spirit of the world is now made up mainly of evil, therefore the crumbling of the world, I mean spiritually, is taking place faster and faster. And this spiritual crumbling, I would want to repeat, results in physical crumbling also. The morals which no longer exist, the spirit of pollution around, brought about also by the physical pollution, for those who would have tried once upon a time to avoid the physical pollution, are now paying obeisance more and more to the God of the physical, the God of greed and of power, material manifestations of godlessness. This inevitably leads to the moral decay from which the world is suffering. If there is decay at the root of a tooth, would not the tooth decay and carry an unpleasant stench and cause great pain to the owner of that tooth, to the one whom it belongs? And would not its stench be noticed and cause unpleasantness to those who come near? It is so. It is the same with what is happening to the earth. Develop spiritual values, the values which are deliberately being pushed into the background and eventually completely away from men's minds. Increase your spiritual values and you will increase the strength of the foundation of the world. It is so. Friend, all heaven watches with the eyes which are given by the Godhead, and all heaven laments the falling away of virtues, the accumulation of vices, the shunning of all things heavenly and morally edifying, and the spreading of woes caused by this demoralization of the world. Come back to the Savior, the God of all goodness. Come back through all the pathways He has set which lead home, and especially the shortest way, the narrowest path, the pathway of His Son. His Son is Savior. God too is Savior. Does not the Son proclaim the Father, serve the Father, do the work of the Father in the name of the Father? Go proclaim Him. Proclaim God. Proclaim the Son. Proclaim the Holy Spirit, for this will be the triumph of the world over its ills. It is the falling away from this proclamation that is destructive. As you fall away from the source of all goodness, inevitably you leave the space created to be filled with the antithesis of this goodness, evil, in all its profanity, in all its destructiveness, often disguised, often shown as good, until the covering is removed, when it is often too late and the filth beneath is exposed, often too late, for many have then fallen to the pit of filth from which they cannot be extricated. Pray, pray inwardly, pray overtly, pray alone and pray collectively, but pray, and the Spirit of the Father and the Son will come and will bless and will help to counteract this unwholesomeness in which the world is becoming entangled. Right, friend. Many who may not be aware of this Holy Spirit and who do not acknowledge the Son are still helped by this Holy Spirit and the Son, of which they are not even aware, is still loving them and wanting to draw them to His bosom. but they are helped in slightly differing ways, and they are supported by the God to whom they pay obeisance and on whom they call in all sincerity, believing in his mercy and in his goodness. For God is merciful, and all those who call upon him are heard by him. But they are not in the same way and in the same tone helped by the Holy Spirit and the Savior, who is the Christ, as those who know and believe and call directly to them. This is not to be taken in any prejudicial way. Let me explain. If you visit a close friend, and when you go to his home, you knock on the door and ask to see the friend whom you know welcomes you, but because you have no love or acceptance of his son or daughter, preferring to ignore them in a stone-faced manner, although you were on the threshold of their father, calling on him, would this not be painful to the father, that his son is treated in this cold matter? Yet because he, God, is merciful, he cannot do otherwise but accept the hand offered to him, to look with mercy and with love and with pity on those who call to him, and to hold out their hand to him. Yet at the same time there is an emptiness and a space which he would like to fill in his heart with the acceptance of his son. Because he is merciful and will not do otherwise, he waits, knowing that some will at some stage accept his son and love him too, and in acknowledgment give praise and honor due. But he knows also the ones who never will. Yet he is merciful. Compensate with your own love in whatever way you can for this remiss. He is, in his greatness, even his almightiness, humble enough to accept your token, for this is what it is, a token for all the love spent on you who accept his family and those who do not. Compensate him, friend, with love, the foundation of all goodness. As you compensate and fill the world with love, it will strengthen to the foundation of the world and stop its crumbling. For there are myriads of tiny doorways to be opened by love, little doorways leading to the strengthening of the foundation of the world. You know of what I speak, and so will many others. Explain to those who may not find it easy to understand. The little doors are the gateways to the souls of men, their minds, their physical needs, their lost hopes, and calcification of the soul. So many little ways in which to spend love, little doorways through which it can enter, take root, and strengthen the foundation of the world. So be it. And my friend has a side note here saying, the doorways are on both sides, from the giver through which he can give love, and from the receiver through which he receives and can be strengthened, taught, buoyed up when necessary. May we be blessed by these holy words from Jesus. I ask this of the Father in Jesus' name. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, Amen.